Hi everyone, my name is Radhika Nair and I'm here to present my research paper, Online Journalism During COVID. As mentioned before, the title of my research paper is Online Journalism During COVID-19, a survey among online journalists in Kerala. I would like to introduce my co-author, Dr. Robbie Augustine, Program Chair, Mass Communication, Navarajna University, and myself, a PhD scholar in the same university. The content of my presentation includes an introduction, abstract, objectives, review of literature, methodology followed for the research, a detailed analysis and the findings, conclusion and reference. The novel coronavirus has changed everything around us. From wearing a mask stands the new normal to work from home becoming a routine, the virus has changed our lives upside down. Global financial crisis, crows losing their jobs, education going completely online. It will be tough to point out one sector which could survive the pandemic without harm. Just like any other sphere, journalism has also been badly impacted by the crisis. From many print media getting stalled to newsroom set up from homes, the pandemic has rather kick-started a new phase in Indian journalism. This research paper intends to have a detailed study on the changes in journalism sector by the impact of the global pandemic. Along with journaling the new techniques adopted by media persons, this research article will also be predicting some of the practices which will be implemented in the newsrooms in future, inspired from the pandemic era. The objectives of the study includes, the study aims to find the changing trends in the field of online journalism, to explore the extent to which the lockdown has influenced the users, to study the struggles the online journalists have undergone during the pandemic, to find out how the work from home has affected the professional as well as the personal life of working journalists, to identify the creative ideas used by journalists to keep the viewers engaged during the pandemic. There was a very interesting article published in Times of India newspaper, which spoke about the work from home culture around the world. And in that research article, there was a mention that the work from home has made working day of an Indian worker increase to 32 minutes longer than their routine style. The article states that Indians spent 30 minutes more at work in April and May as compared to the beginning of year. In another article published by New Indian Express, the title of the article was Global Pandemic, Social Media and Digital Distancing. This article spoke about the role of social media during the pandemic. As per the article, the degree of media panic, the amount of media consumption, and the consequent changes in public relation have been much higher during COVID-19. In another article published in First Post, the title was Nipah Virus, Kerala Floods, and now COVID-19, Malayalam media's coverage of crisis offers a model worth replicating for constructive journalism. The news article details the role played by the Malayalam news media during the outbreak of unfortunate events like Kerala Floods of 2018-19, Nipah virus outbreak in 2018-19, and the ongoing COVID pandemic. The article says that the Malayalam news media focused on solution-based journalism, which resulted in guiding people towards measures or a preventive cure to overcome the crisis. The author also opines that Malayalam news media's constructive involvement in recent events of crisis is a model to emulate. Methodology. Methodology I have followed for the survey, for the research paper. The qualitative method is used for the study to collect primary data. An online questionnaire survey was conducted among online journalists in Kerala. Through a convenient sampling method, 20 responses were collected from the journalists from different media houses. The survey was conducted among 20 online journalists from Kerala who represent different reputed organizations from both the regional language Malayalam and the English language. Now let's get into the analysis and the findings I could get from the survey. Working hours. I have asked the respondents to record the number of hours they used to work before the pandemic, and about 50% of my respondents say that they work between 6 to 8 hours, whereas a 45% gave me a response that they work 8 to 10 hours. And in the next question, when they were asked to record the working hours during work from home, 30% of my respondents said that they work between 6 to 8 hours. 25% recorded that they work 8 to 10 hours. And 30% of the respondents said that they work more than 10 hours. So I could come to a conclusion that as per the survey, 55% of the online journalists were or are working more than 8 hours in recent times. The next question which I gave to my respondents were to talk about the main source of news during the pandemic. The options I gave them was field reporting, social media, news agencies, and other websites. And surprisingly, 90% of my respondents recorded that their main source of income, main source of news during the pandemic was social media. 90% of the respondents of the survey shared that social media was the main source of news during the pandemic. The next question was to learn about the quality of work during the pandemic. And I gave them a statement, your quality of work increased during pandemic. And 40% of my respondents agree to the statement, whereas 15% of the same strongly agreed with the statement. So I could come to a conclusion that 55% of the respondent agreed that their quality of work increased during the lockdown. Talking about the technical knowledge the online journalists have acquired during the pandemic or the work from home time, I gave them the statement that my technical knowledge increased during the work from home phase. And 35% of my respondents strongly agree to it, and 25% agree to it. And whereas 30% gave me a neutral response. So I could come to a conclusion that 60% of the journalists opinionated that their technical skills were improved during the work from home phase. The next question was to learn about the mental health of the online journalists during the work from home phase. And the statement I gave to them was, I have undergone depression during work from home. 25% strongly agree to that, 30% agree to the statement. So I could come to a conclusion that 55% of my respondents opened up that they have suffered from depression during this time. Talking about disinformation, 65% of my respondents shared that they have noticed disinformation during the pandemic. Talking about readership and lockdown, it was surprising to find that 65% of my respondents gave me a response that the online readership increased during the pandemic. 63% of the online journalists from Kerala have stated that their readerships have increased during the pandemic. Talking about the advantages the pandemic have brought to online journalism, I just correlated some of the answers given by my respondents. They are, Zoom interviews became more popular, readers increased, and more opportunities in online journalism, more output, changed work culture and workflow. They also said that work can go on even without an office space. People depend more on social media. More innovations came forward, focusing on topics in depth. Whereas, on the other hand, the disadvantages suggested by my respondents were loss in profit making, fake journalism increased, scarcity of ad revenue, disinformation, lack of authenticity, no work-life balance, more working hours, lack of teamwork. Hence, I came to a conclusion that the working hours of the online journalist have increased during work from home. Social media is or was the main source of news during the pandemic. The technical knowledge of online journalists have been improved during the pandemic. The quality as well as the quantity of work has been improved during the work from home phase. Even though there were not many physical issues, the majority of online journalists experienced depression during work from home. And surprisingly, the readership of Malayalam online portals have increased during the pandemic. Here are some examples of the references which I took for the survey. That's it about my presentation. Thank you so much.